if it suddenly drops out. I say that just for the record. But we are going to record it. So we'll have that up on the website with a link. So if you want to go back and watch this afterwards, we'll also give details at the end of how you can actually register your interest if you haven't done already, and what that will allow us to do. And also there'll be an email address at the end that you can send any questions into. So lots of ways of getting involved once we've done this. But just to talk you through the agenda now, we're going to start talking a little bit about why we went down this route of the academy. And for that, I'll introduce my co-owner, Nick Hutt. I'm Greg Lake, by the way, should have said that, but I'm one of the owners of co-owners of Billericay Town FC. And so I'm going to host this, so you're going to have to put up with me a lot. Apologise in advance. And then we're going to do a video. You may already have seen it, but it shows you the Billericay Town facilities. It's got some music with it. It kind of jazzes up the evening rather than just us talking. We'll let Nick continue and do a piece around our pathway and the way that our teams are set up at the moment, just to tell you a little bit more. I know that some of the people on this call are already part of the Billericay Town family and playing for our age group teams, but it will, for those that aren't involved at the moment, allow you to get a little bit more background and see where you might fit into that pathway. Then we'll switch over and do a video on Chelmsford College. So a little bit of the facilities there. And then Dave Cornwall, who's running this from the college side, will then talk to you for a couple of minutes about the process and the history of Chelmsford in terms of academies and where we go forward from there. Then we'll meet the coaches, some of whom you can probably see. They'll introduce themselves. They won't go on for ages, I promise, because I'll stop them. But it is a good chance to meet the people that, if you do come onto the academy, you'll be working with from the football side. We'll then get a couple of our first team players. We've got, I can see Jay. So Jay Blackie from our women's first team squad, and also Laurie Wilson. Can't see Laurie yet, but I'm sure he'll be here by then, who's playing for our men's first team. So a little bit about what it's like to play for Billericay, their past, their academy past, the dogs barking, and just a little bit more about why it's important to us. Then we'll open up for questions. We will take questions as we go, but also we'll do a little bit at the end, and we'll wrap up with kind of next steps. So that's what we're going to run through. Allow people to get some questions in, learn a little bit more, and we'll try and keep this to an hour so that people can go back to their lives. So with that in mind, I wanted to introduce Nick Hutt. I've already said Nick is one of the co-owners of Billericay Town. Just to go through why we're passionate about this academy initiative and the thought process in terms of getting to this stage and our partnership with Chelmsford College. Nick, can I hand over to you?
Yeah, so Greg and I were part of the consortium that took over the football club in October of 2019. When we joined, we had a number of priorities for the football club, and establishing this academy was one of those top priorities. The main reason for establishing it is obviously to complete our pathway for both men and women. And we'll come back to talk about the pathway and the pathway structure in a few moments. But when we were thinking about the academy program, we really thought quite long and hard about what our value proposition should be in terms of this academy program. And we really think about it in four different sections that I'll come on to. But what I would say is I would encourage you all to look around if you're interested in this type of program. Look at what other people are doing, but I would say keep in mind what we believe our value proposition is, and perhaps that will help you in terms of comparing and contrasting some of the programs that you may be interested in. So in no particular order, one of the key components for us was the coaching. So we wanted to get the best possible group of coaches on the football side to help you grow and develop as young footballers. We wanted people involved in the program that have played at a very high level. And when the coaches introduce themselves, I think you'll see that, so that they can talk to you about what it's actually like to progress as a young football player. And we also wanted people that were dedicated to working and developing and mentoring young people. And again, I think you'll see a lot of those credentials when the coaches introduce themselves. So number one was coaching. Number two, the education. So we wanted to be in a position to offer you as broad a spectrum of further education options as we possibly could. You'll see a lot of schemes that do just offer the BTEC in sport. Nothing wrong with a BTEC in sport. And we will offer that course as well, but we also wanted to offer you a variety of alternatives. And Dave will talk about some of those later and answer questions that you may have. Third was the pathway. So we want a pathway. We genuinely want that, and we wanted to construct this so that we achieve that objective. So a lot of that is about having continuity in the coaches. So I think you'll see this evening that, you know, there's continuity in terms of coaches involved in our senior teams, that those senior coaches will be watching you play and train, and you will therefore be visible to the football club. So the third thing was the pathway. And again, we'll come back in a few moments to the pathway. And the fourth pillar was the facilities. So I think probably now, Greg's a good time to move on to the video and to show everybody where they will be training and playing.
So in terms of the pathway, just to talk that through, you know, at the moment, the girls' side starts at under 10. We've got plans next year to start that at under 6. That will go all the way through to a under 18 side, a development side, a reserves and a women's first team. And we'll hear from Jay later. On the boys' side, we've got a very strong cult set up, starting at under 6 and going all the way through that pathway as well. And what the intention is that when we've got these academy sides going, you know, and we're looking for 20 students for the girls at under 19 level, because that's the way that league works and the way that we work that side, plus 20 boys at under 17 and 20 boys at under 19. And we'll be looking at feeding those in, if they're not playing for other people and willing to, into our pathway. You know, this is a partially for the football club about bringing our own players in, that, you know, one of our own is something that we need to do. And you know, you'll hear that, you know, part of that video that we showed with the young man scoring a goal, he was actually part of our under 18, under 23 setup and was playing for the first team. In terms of the women's side, we've actually had a 16-year-old, Millie Stacey, start and make a debut for the first team this season. So it's very much something that, from a football perspective, we want to promote and push and start building our own players. And having the academy is something we're very keen on doing. We're a family club. When you get to come to the trials, when we're allowed to get you into the clubhouse, you'll find that actually it does feel like a family. And it's one of the reasons that when Nick and I got involved in owning the club, that we wanted to be part of this and while we're trying to build it. So very strong pathways, and the academies have got an opportunity to get into that. And you know, we want to build footballers who can be the best footballers that they can be. And when, as Nick said, when you get to meet the coaches, then you'll find that that's definitely the case. At this point, I'm going to try and hand over to Dave Cornwall to talk about more of the Chelmsford and the college and the education side. We did have a video to play. We'll make sure that that's available from our website on the Academy page, because I suspect if we try that, we may get into the same issues that we were having with people disrupting. And Richie's trying to keep a lid on that at the moment. So, Dave, I don't know if you can get off mute.
I think that's okay. Can everybody hear me?
You're there, sir.
Great. Okay. Good evening, everyone. My name is David Cornwall. I'm the Academy Director and Business Manager at Chelmsford College. I've been involved in setting up football academies now for the last 10 years, along with some of the coaching staff you're about to hear from. So together, we've seen 4 players progress into professional football and over 30 progress into non-league football. We've also had players that were offered scholarships in the United States too. So really successful over the last 10 years. Myself and Kirk are A-licensed coaches, and we've also had 2 ex-professional players in our coaching team, including Stuart Slater, who made over 200 appearances for West Ham. Stuart coaches some of the technical skills with the players, and even now, many find it difficult sometimes to perfect what he wants. There's also coaching staff here who have worked with professional clubs and with Billericay Town. So together, we really do know what it takes to become a successful player. I myself, along with Dan Worthington, have spent considerable time in the United States working with clubs and universities with both boys and girls football programs. I'm mostly based at Chelmsford College, which really is a great, safe place to be. The staff are extremely helpful, very friendly, and they always have students' futures on their minds. There's expertise in many subjects, including teachers that have worked in the industry they currently teach in. And for those of you who have sort of struggled a little bit with their mental health over the last year or so during lockdown, there's also counsellors available to talk to too. The college offers many different courses, but if you want to play and study and be part of the football academy, you can choose between business, accountancy, engineering, carpentry, and there's 2 sports courses available, 1 at level 2 and 1 at level 3. So for those of you who are not familiar with the levels, level 2 being GCSE level and level 3 being A-level standard. You would have seen from on the Chelmsford College website a video. If you haven't, take a look at it. And the college is split into 2 campuses. Our Prince's Road campus, where most of the trades are taught. So that would be stuff like catering, carpentry, painting and decorating, brickwork, engineering and hair and beauty. And our Morsham Street campus caters for pretty much everything else. Sport is based at Morsham Street, along with the sports hall, dance studio, gym and squash courts. The gym is free for everyone to use, but you've obviously need to be inducted into the gym, and there are gym instructors there that can do that for you. There's also many more enrichment activities that you can join too. Once you enrol, your timetable will include gaps for your training and your matches. Training will take place over 2 venues, one at Billericay Town Football Club and the other on the 3G pitch at Melbourne Park in Chelmsford. There will also be some skill sessions in the college sports hall, usually on a Tuesday lunchtime-ish. The girls will train and play home matches at Billericay Town, and the boys will be split between Billericay and Chelmsford with an under-17 team and under-19 team, both training and playing at Billericay. and two development squads training and playing at Chelmsford. This isn't like a school or other football academies where you go to lessons and then attend an after-school football club. This is going to be run exactly the same as how professional football clubs run their academies. So your training time and your match time are timetabled around your studies. So training times for the week are on Monday, you'll train from 9.30 to 11.30. Tuesday from 12.15 till 2.15. So Wednesday is match day, so the afternoons will be free. Thursday, there's no training at all, so I would imagine that will be a full day at college. And Friday is the same as Monday, 9.30 to 11.30. Chelmsford College also work in collaboration with Rittle University. It's going to enable players to be involved with the sports science surrounding physical performance. You could be tested and guided in your athletic development and physical preparation for both at training ground and at the university labs. Your timetable may also include a gap here and there, and this will enable you to catch up with college work in one of our assessment centres or access our strength and conditioning sessions with one of our gym instructors in the college gym or dance studio. Staff can also help you with health and nutrition, with a health and nutrition plan, if that's what's required too. So, please take note that there'll be less gaps on your timetable if you're required to resit English or maths. So my advice to you really is to study hard in those two subjects particularly. For those training at Billericay Town, a 60-seater coach will be waiting to bring all of you back to the college immediately after training, so that you can get to your studies on time. You can then make your own way home from college, no different from any other college student. Wednesday is match day, and if your timetable to attend college for studies on a Wednesday morning, to take you, there's three college minibuses to take you to bring you back from the game, so they can take you to the game and bring you home again. All of our teams will play Wednesday afternoon. They're all playing in different leagues. And at different levels. So match day kit will be provided and there'll be more details coming out soon on how you can access your training kit. The progression, both academically and from a football point of view, is immense. You've already sort of seen the progression from the football side, but from an academic side, we're one of the only academies where you can stay for 3 years. That's if you want to, as long as you're under 19. Our information and advice and guidance department at the college is a large team, and they can guide you through all of your next steps after college. If university is an option, then they can help you apply and help you write your academic statements. And if you want to progress to the next level of your course at college, they, along with the subject tutors, can help you do that too. Personally, I think one of the best things about our academy is the opportunity for you to progress into one of our apprenticeship programs. I help manage around 20 different apprenticeship programs at Chelmsford College, and our employer engagement team have some really excellent relationships with many employers in a variety of industry. This isn't a program where you play football for 2 years and we say goodbye. With all football academies, there should be a progression, and there should be progression opportunities for everyone. So whether you manage to get a place with us or not, check the progression opportunities on offer before you sign up. It'd be amazing if any of the staff in our academy could help you progress into professional football. It'd be brilliant if Chelmsford College could help you progress to university or a scholarship in the United States. And we'd be overjoyed if you progressed into Billericay Town's first team whilst working and training on one of our apprenticeship programmes. Chelmsford College, just so you know, if you've got a pen and paper there, Chelmsford College are holding their open evenings next week on Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. So this will give you an opportunity to listen to the curriculum area managers of the subjects that you're interested in, and also enable you to ask questions. You can also apply for your chosen course on the college website straight after. All the information is on the Chelmsford College website, so please take a look. Now, I know everyone's circumstances are different, so if you want to contact me to ask any questions, feel free to contact me on 01245 293 119, or you can email me. My email address is on the Chelmsford College website, but for those that have got a pen and paper ready, it's cornwelld@chelmsford.ac.uk. Right, due to the current issues surrounding coronavirus, I'm currently working from home. So please leave a message if you can, and I can pick up all voicemail messages from home. So I hope the information that I've just given you has been informative. I'll pass you back to Greg now, who will introduce you to the coaching staff.
Well, I will, Dave, but I've got a couple of questions actually for you that have come through while you were talking. And as this part of it's going well with no interruptions, I'm kind of keen not to move on for a second. So one of them is, how will we know whether we've got in, whether we've been successful or not? And I guess there's two parts to that, isn't there? You know, one is the football side, and we will have trials as soon as we can. And the other is the college side, which I was going to ask you to answer.
Okay, right. So from the college side of view, there should really be a course for everybody there at different levels. So if you do find a course on the college website there that you're interested in, or you know what course you're already interested in from the choices that I just explained in my little sort of presentation there, then apply for those. Carpentry, there's level one qualifications. They start at level one, and that's the real basics. Accountancy starts at level two. Engineering and sport, you can do level three qualifications as well. So there's levels there for everybody, depending on what course you'd like to choose.
Brilliant. A couple more questions for you, Dave. What league will the girls play in on Wednesday afternoons?
Okay, so at the moment we're looking at a couple of leagues at the moment. The preferred choice may be the English Colleges League, which is the under 19 league. All of the leagues are under 19, all age groups play in those leagues. So if you're 16, 17 and 18, you'll all play in an under 19 league. So, I don't think we've made that decision yet as to which league the girls will play in, but it looks highly likely that it'll be the English Colleges League.
And same for the boys, how many squads are we going to have? And what leagues are they likely to play in?
Okay, so the under 19 and under 17 boys based at Billericay Town will play in the National League, which is a national league. It's all over the country. There's 120 teams in that league, they're all split into various areas of the country. Both those teams will play in that league. For the development squads, the two boys development squads, they'll play in more local leagues, it's usually an Essex type league.
And then final one, and then I'll let you off, Dave. Do I apply for football at Chelmsford College through Chelmsford College or through Billericay Academy? And we'll do this one together, shall we? So, you know, in terms of the football side, we will be holding trials. We believe that if things keep going the way they are at the moment, we should be able to do that March, early April, but we'll certainly be doing that. In terms of the education, Dave, I think you'll be putting more information, but...
Yeah, so my advice really is to tune in. If you go onto the Chelmsford College website, you've got an opportunity there to listen to all the tutors of the programmes that you're interested in. They're split over Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. They'll explain the courses to you. And you can apply online straight after, and you can ask as many questions as you like on that night. So go onto the college website and have a look at what night those courses are being spoken about.
And is there a deadline for those college applications, Dave?
The trade type occupations, carpentry, that type of thing, engineering, they tend to fill up pretty quick. Sport fills up very quick as well, as you can imagine. But the college is very popular. It's a good college. It's an excellent place to be, and there's a lot of students that want to come. So the quicker you can complete that application form on the college website, the quicker you'll get your interview. So I would do that pretty quick.
Okay, got somebody asking about what comes in the kit package. We'll cover that off later. But nice stuff like this. We've got people asking about particular courses they've already applied for at Chelmsford and whether they will match up to the academy timetable, Dave.
Okay.
And then I really will let you alone after that.
If you have chosen something which I haven't spoken about, which wasn't included in the Football Academy programme, I would suggest that you contact me separately and we can talk about that. We have had instances in the past where somebody wanted to do IT. I went and spoke to the curriculum area manager for IT, and we managed to free their timetable up a little bit so that they could access the Football Academy.
Brilliant, thank you. There are another couple of questions. I'm going to move it on though, so apologies if I've missed your question. We'll come back to it if we've got time at the end. If not, I've got the notes here of who's asking, and I'll make sure if you send me your email address that I answer those personally. But let's get to meet the coaches. This is exciting. We'll try and see if we can do this. So we're going to start with Scott Chickleday. Scott, are you there? Can you come off mute for me and just introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm here. Sorry, Greg.
It's all right.
Dr. Greg, I'm Scott Chickleday. I'm the ladies' first team manager. A quick bit of background. Then I moved from Tottenham to Queen's Park Rangers. I had 2 years there. And now I do. We've got a good squad. We're quite reliant on bringing young players through. So there's a good pathway from the lower age groups coming up into the first team. Like Greg said, we had 2 17-year-olds and I think 3 or 4 18-year-olds as well. So we've got a fairly young, it's a mixed squad really. We've got some young players to sort of mid-20 players. And it's been really good. So like I said, it's a fantastic club, great environment for players to come into. And like I said, we cherish the players that come through the lower age groups and progress into the first team. And like I said, it's a great pathway, and the way things are going with the additions that Kim and Greg have done on the women's side, which has been fantastic, is the club's just getting bigger and stronger, and hopefully this is gonna add what we need to add and obviously give us a little bit of a feeder into the 3 senior teams that we've got.
Okay, thanks Scott. And Scott will be ably assisted by Terry, who I can see just above him there. Terry, if you can come off mute and just do a quick intro.
Hi guys, I'm Terry Harrison. I am the assistant manager to Scott with the ladies' first team. My previous clubs have been Charlton, Balbs and Pitsey, Harlow, as well as Epping. I've been coaching about 11 years. And really excited to get the academy off the ground and create a really good positive pathway for the girls to hopefully get in the Billy Rickey first team.
Thank you very much. We'll move on to the boys and do the under-17s. So, Stuart Slater, if you're there, sir, can you take yourself off mute and just do your quick intro?
Yeah.
Stuart,
yeah, can you hear me, everyone?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We've got you.
Yeah, I'm there. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, yeah, good evening, everyone. Hope you're all well, safe. Yeah. My name's Stuart Slater. I'm a former professional footballer. I played at West Ham. Celtic, I played over 200-300 games for them, West Ham, Celtic, Ipswich, Leicester. Had a 20-year pro career under some great managers, on some England managers, some national managers as well. So I've been coaching now for about 20 years. I coached at West Ham for 5 years, director of football at schools. I've been coaching in the college academy now for last 10 years. But what's so important to me is, you know, all the 20 years experience that I had playing at all these different clubs and playing under these different managers. I just, you know, want to give something back to communities, to boys that are playing, that, you know, obviously I put my own stamp on it as well. But, you know, just what it's like to be a professional footballer. The dedication, the hard work, the, you know, obviously the respect for one another, all these things that, you know, potentially could make you a decent footballer, but also to make you a decent human being. I mean, that's a big thing for me as well. Values, you know, off the pitch as well. Not only on the pitch, but off the pitch. I mean, obviously Billy Rickey, the facilities are unbelievable. That's why I went to West Ham. The facilities were great there. It was a community place. All the people that were here tonight that you see, They've got the club at heart, and that's why it makes it an exciting, you know, venue. So, you know, hope you're all excited about this, because I certainly am, and you know, look forward to signing you all up.
Brilliant, thanks, Stuart. And Stuart will be ably assisted by somebody who was a product of a previous Chelmsford Academy season, I believe. So, Ash Goss, are you there, sir?
I am here. How are you doing, guys? Hope you're all okay and healthy, safe and well. So obviously, like, well, 7-8 years ago, I was one of these young players on an open evening. Obviously, back then, it wasn't a virtual one. I was able to go into the college before the pandemic. And yeah, I started the college programme and the academy myself. And luckily enough, I was a player that was able to, under Stuart, who just met, and you're going to meet Kirk later on, we managed to sort of win the league and we done really well. But what I would say is, as much as we all have a passion for the football, we really, really put an emphasis on the education. Well, I know as a player under the guys that are going to be coaching you as well, they really did put an emphasis on it. And from what I've done for the education side of things, I've really taken to my working world. So I've managed to set up my own sort of coaching company. And I still speak to the college teachers, Kirk and Stuart and Dave, and all the people that have really supported me in my life. At 24 years old, I've done quite a lot in the coaching world. And I believe it all come from the professional attributes that come from the academy and come from the college. And I'm sure it'll be no different for you guys when you guys come in. So yeah, I'm just excited to meet you all. And like you say, 7-8 years ago, I was just like you. So I'm hoping that I can still put the same input in as I got back then.
Brilliant. Thanks, Ash. Moving on to the under-19s. So Kirk Game is going to be leading that group. Kirk?
Hear me?
Yeah.
Hi everyone. My name's Kirk Gay. I'm the Academy Under-19 Boys Manager. I'm a former professional football player, Premier League Academy coach. That's where I met Stuart at West Ham United. Hold the UEFA licence along with David. I'm a qualified personal trainer and a level 4 strength and conditioning coach as well. I've been involved in this football education academy programmes for the past 10 years. During that time, I've helped many boys go on to play semi-professional and professional football. But what's really drawn me to this kind of programme is, alongside that, all the boys have achieved academic and vocational qualifications. And it really ensures that they've backed up their playing careers. As far as my football philosophy goes, I always try to encourage the boys to train and play with intensity, enthusiasm, and try to be the best versions of themselves each day. I always want my teams to dominate possession, force opponents really to adapt to our style of play, in a manner really that the boys enjoy and others find a pleasure to watch. That's really important. But anyway, I believe that the academy that we've got up and running is a fantastic opportunity for everyone. Can't wait to get the season started and see all the new recruits.
Brilliant. Thanks, Kirk. And last but not least, Kirk with the under-19s will be supported by Dan Worthington. Good evening, Dan.
Cheers, Greg. Hi, everyone. Hope you're keeping well during this difficult time. My name's Dan Worthington. I'm the Academy goalkeeping coach, and I'll also be assisting Kirk with the under-19 boys side. A little bit about my coaching background. Previously worked at Dagenham Redbridge, West Ham. I've worked in the States over a number of years for West Ham, Wolves and other Category 1 clubs. I run my own goalkeeping coaching business full time. We coach between 150, 200 goalkeepers a week. And we've had a fair bit of success with having both boys and girls signed by pro clubs. I like my goalkeepers to defend the goal, the area and the space. I like my goalkeeper to be able to build up play and also break lines. And my sessions are fun, challenging, high tempo and very much game related. And I'd just like to say, can't wait to get to meet all you when we eventually have the trials.
Brilliant. Thank you, Dan. So basically, that's the coaching stuff, folks. So they will be looking after you if you do come on board. Just before we kind of break, because we have been going for a while now, I wanted to introduce you to a couple of our first team players, just so they can tell you a little bit about how they made it to where they are and where the academy fits and their views on the academy. So with the concept of ladies first, I'm going to hand you over to Jay Blackie, who plays for our women's first team. Good evening, Jay.
Right. Good evening, everyone. Hope everyone's all right. I'm one of the ladies' first team players. When we talk about the experienced players, I'm at that end of the spectrum. But football has kind of been my life. I've played for about 26 years at many different levels, but it also included academy level. I think when I come out of school, I was one of these players, you know, I just wanted to play football. I didn't really know what else I wanted to do. So to find an education alongside playing football was just perfect for me. At the time, I did the level 3 sports BTEC course with, again, no kind of idea of where I wanted to go with after that. And eventually used that qualification to go to university at the age of 29. So, you know, that many years later, it was so beneficial to make sure that I still got that. But football-wise, I have not got enough time to tell you how many clubs I've played at. And plus, every girl on my team will laugh at me if I sit here and list them. But, you know, at 17, I played in what was the old Women's Premiership against some of the top players in the country that were playing for England at the time. And again, that came out of playing academy football, playing 3 times a week, 4 times a week, including my Sunday league at the time, 5 times a week. You know, it just... It made football a possibility for me, which back when I was your age, you know, there wasn't many opportunities, but there's so many now that, you know, if you want to make it to the top, you know, academy has got to be part of that pathway. I think the positives about Billericay is that we are a family club. You know, we are a team. We come together, and that's from, you know, our baby teams all the way through to our ladies' first team. We go and watch each other across the men's team. You know, the relationships are there. We watch each other's games. You know, there's just a real good value base at this club. I think the other thing for me, opportunities, I do hold my A license, my 1, 2 and 3 while at academy. So I was only 21 while getting my UEFA B. So, yeah, lots of opportunities, and I would just, you know, push you to go for it. And it's a great opportunity with Chelmsford and Billericay.
Thank you, Jay. That was brilliant. And last but not least, to close the show from our men's first team, Laurie Wilson. Laurie, how are you?
Great, thank you. Hi, everyone. I hope you're all well. I'm Laurie Wilson, and I obviously play in the first team at the moment at Billericay. I've been a professional for about 17, 18 years now. And like Jay, I probably won't name them all because we'll probably be there for another hour if I name every team that I played for. But just a few, I was at Stevenage through from conference level to League 2, League 1. I was at Charlton as well, played in the Championship for 3 or 4 years with them. And I was also at Bolton Wanderers again in the Championship for a few more years and at various loans and everywhere else. But I was at Charlton's Academy from the age of 9 to about 18. And my education for me was so important, and it was pushed from my parents, to be honest with you. And luckily enough that I was able to do my A-levels whilst I was in the academy still, which was a massive role that it played for me as I went further on in my career. And as I got older and as you start coming towards the end of your career, you do start to, you know, wonder what am I going to do afterwards, what I'm going to do afterwards. And it's actually the stepping stones that you take at the start of your career at the ages of 16, 17 and 18, which play a huge role for you when you are leaving, to get those qualifications in then leaves you in a much better state when you are finishing your career. And I would say that the opportunities of being a professional footballer and being in the environment of an academy are huge. You see the progression of players move so fast when they're in academies, that from going from training, you know, with your friends once or twice a week or playing the game once a week and that's it, to suddenly training 2, 3, 4 times a week and playing games, you'll see a much better understanding of the game. You'll start seeing physically and mentally that players will grow so quickly. And also academies give you this platform. That's how I always saw it, was that being in an academy gave me this platform that every time I went out to play, I always knew that there'd be people watching. You know, whoever that was, you know, whether it be teams higher up in the league, whether it be anybody, I always used to think that somebody out there will be watching. So every time I played, I always gave everything that I ever that I could. And I, that probably plays a part in my career now, being at now 33, 34, and the way that I was taught, you know, the environment that I was brought up in from Charlton from an early age plays a big role in how I am on and off the field now as an old pro. So I would probably say as well, the club are taking huge steps in the facilities that they've got now, the pitches, and for any young aspiring footballer to be playing on those pitches and being in that environment is huge. And, you know, they are the leaders, I would say, now in academy level, at this level, this club's going to be the leader and showing the pathway for every other club going forward. And it's something that I'm really excited about, and I hope that you are too.
Thank you, Laurie. And we are all excited about it. That brings us to the end, really, of the kind of introductions. If anybody's got any more questions, if you want to put them in chat, then we'll answer them. We won't try and open everybody up again. Apologies again for the issues that we had early on. Some of that was outside of our control, but at least we've managed to get through this. But this is the start of working with you all to answer any questions, to get more information out to you on both the education side and on the football side. I hope that you've seen the passion come through. Rich, if you can share your desktop just as I kind of close this out with that final slide in terms of the email address. I would ask people to register your interest, which you can do via the Billericay Town website on the Academy page. What that allows us to do, I know it means leaving a little bit of your own information, but it allows us to talk to you individually, and particularly on the education side, when you want to talk about specific courses and talk to Dave, then he can have that start that one-to-one process with you. And everybody who's registered thus far, unless you've just registered in the last couple of hours, Dave's already started that by sending an email to you and to get that process going. You can see there, hopefully, the Academy website address, but also there's the email address for the Academy, and those emails come through to me, but I'll also pass them on to any of the coaches. So if you've got any particular football questions that you want to ask of the coaches for the different teams, then I will take those and pass them on and get an answer for you. If you want to ask Jay or Laurie a question, or indeed we've got Kim Costry, who was on the call tonight, Dan Brown, they're heads of the women's and girls section and the boys section, the Colts. Dan Brown was also recently our interim manager, so has an involvement across that whole pathway on the boys' side. So whatever your questions, really, let's start this conversation now. We will run a few more sessions about particular topics, which, again, if you've registered, we'll invite you along to. And then as soon as we can actually open things up again and we're allowed, we'll get you down to the facility. Obviously, we'll start organising trials as soon as we possibly can. But we'll get that conversation going and hopefully bring you into the Billericay Town family. Thank you for attending. Thank you for your patience at the beginning. Thank you to everybody from our side who's presented or introduced themselves tonight. We are very excited about this, and there'll be far more as we go forward. Thank you. There will be an after show party now. We'll be passing around peanuts. There may be the odd game. Possibly drinks, if you've got them in your own house, because unfortunately I can't buy them for you. But by all means, please send us your questions in, and let's get that conversation flowing. People are starting to drift away now. We've lost a whole two people, three people. So we'll let everybody go about their evenings. Thank you once again.